Today is the fifth day of lockdown, and we've heard so many things happen in this few days. The police and the army had their hands full. People disobeyed the call to lockdown. Taxis does not obey to the call of numbers in their vehicles. Moving of homeless people has become a challenge in Cape Town. People found drunk on the street while others is sick and dying. Essential workers working tirelessly. Others live life like it's business as usual. And I'm mindful of the people who lives in shacks with a limited space of movement. And it's my prayer today for wisdom from God for our government leaders and everybody in charge of this COVID-19. As God's church, we are required to obey our leaders of the day. Romans 13 verse 1, let everyone be subject to the governing authorities, for there is no authority except that which God has established. Paul is speaking about how believers are to live in love and harmony with the government, but with all people. In Paul's days, there was no Christian consensus or Christian-based constitutional laws. God wants us to work alongside our leaders and support them wherever we can, provincial, local, as well as national. I know that some of the laws from government we will find in total conflict with what we think is best. But we should never forget in whose image we are created. Submission and obedience is not the same. Obedience relates to the outward performances, while submission touches the attitude of the heart. We may not always be able to obey and agree to those over us, but we can always have a heart as we got a heart to God. May us today be in full obedience and do what is expected of us. Stay at home unless we need something urgently in order to keep ourselves safe and the rest of our country safe and our family safe. And by doing that, we will make God's heart happy to see that his children is in obedience to the orders of the day. May God bless us. May God be with us. And may we do the right thing so that we have nothing to fear from it. We give you thanks, Heavenly Father, for your word this evening and for the people that you have put in place in government. We pray for them, our president and all leaders and everybody, Lord, working tirelessly to help us as a country. In Jesus' name, amen.